is going on, everybody? This is Jepp, and today I'm going to show you something way different from the things you're used to see on this channel. Today I'm going to walk you through the whole process that's behind each single one of my videos, and we are going to record together When the Sun Goes Down by the Arctic Monkeys. That's some sort of one-man band, because I'm planning to record the two guitar tracks, a bass track, a voice track, and a friend of mine helped me with the drums. So I'm gonna show you how I started with an idea and I convert it in a video, step by step. And this might be useful for some of you that might decide to start working on this platform and having fun creating content and sharing it with the whole world, or for some of you that are just curious to know what's behind a YouTube video. I think this might be very informative, so here I am. Before starting, it's very important that I make a list of the items, physical or like software, you need in order to do something like this. First, we divide this list in production and post-production. The production part is, of course, focused on creating video and audio content. The post-production is mainly software-based, and that serves the purpose of mixing the sounds together. For the production area, of course, we need a video camera. It's not necessary that's an actual camera. You might also use your phone's one. It's no secret that I've often used my phone to record some of my videos. But right now I'm using a Handycam by Sony. I'm gonna show it to you. That's the video part, basically. Then you will need the instrument you would like to play and you would like to record. Of course, you might use a bass or a guitar that have amplified systems, or you might use your own voice, flutes, trumpets, any other instrument that doesn't have built-in amplification. In that case, you might also need a microphone. It's very important to have these two things: video camera and the instrument you want to play. But then, what you really need in order to create the sound and work with it is an audio interface or audio device. I'm using a very old one that has accompanied me for basically the last 7 years, so it might be a nice time to replace it with something a little bit more, you know, fresh. And this is it. This is a Focusrite Scarlett 2i2. So the last thing that's very important for production, but also as we will be able to see in the post-production, is a software that can record the sound you are giving through this audio interface. You might use GarageBand if you are a Mac user. You might find good versions of Logic if you are a Windows or Mac user. I'm pretty sure that there are plenty of programs out there in order to record and mix the music you are producing with your instrument. Optional, but pretty good in order to listen to what you are playing. A nice pair of headphones, any types of where were we? I was just chanting about how wonderful my video camera was when she randomly decided to remove sound from half of my footage. And I just realized it right now while I was editing the video, forcing me to turn the camera on again and record the missing footage during the night. Exactly. The production part is gone. You recorded your sound, you mixed it with GarageBand or Logic, and you have your track, all right? So you have the sound to your video. Now you need to record the video. You did it. You recorded yourself while playing or singing that song. Now the last and probably the most boring part begins, the post-production. You need the audio software we mentioned earlier that you should already have in your hands. For example, we said GarageBand or Logic, and you need a video software like iMovie, for example, or Sony Vegas Pro, because what you need to do now is take the two things you produced, so the music and the video, and sync them up so that the part that you played will perfectly be synchronized with the audio you produce. So once you've done this, you have a much better quality compared to the potential of just plugging your guitar, your amplifier, and recording it with your camera. But at the same time, you have a great, great product. Before showing you the whole process, I'm gonna just sum things up for you. I'm gonna first record all the tracks that compose my song. Of course, we will start from the rhythmic part, so drums and bass. I already have drums, so I just have to record bass. But before recording bass, I will record a temporary vocal part so that I can follow the song. After that, we go to rhythmic guitar and soloist guitar. Once the track is done and everything's recorded, I mix all the instruments up and then I create the track that will be the basement for my video. After that, I'm gonna start recording videos where I just play the parts I already recorded. Once I'm done with all of this, I will create just one video, just one product on all of your screens every Saturday. So let's get into it. Peace, guys. So before recording the bass part, the drum track is already in GarageBand. I usually like to record very simple vocal part just to follow the song while I'm playing the bass and there's just the drums as a track. So it will help me know where we are at while we record the song. So I'm gonna show it to you. Avert your eyes and staring at the ground. She makes a subtle proposition. I'm sorry, love, I'll have to turn you down. And though it must be up to somewhat, what are the chances to her? It's more than likely. And I've got a feeling in my stomach and start to wonder what his story might be. What his story might be. Yes, it changes when the sun goes down. Yes, it changes when the sun goes down. They say it changes when the sun goes down. Around here, around here. So I'll do this the whole track and I will record the bass afterwards. Temporary vocal part recorded. Now I'm ready to record my bass. We're advancing with our record session. We've just finished the bass. It sounds pretty good. So I've decided to record the rhythmic guitar, which is the next on the list, without my headphones on. And then I'm gonna adjust all the parts where I haven't been accurate enough later. And yeah, I want to let you hear at which point of the song we are right now. Okay, so select rhythmic guitar track and I play record. So now you will hear the drum tracks, the bass track I recorded, and the audio part, the temporary vocal part I recorded to follow the song. And the song is starting to take its final shape. So it's this. So what is going on, everybody? This is so day two of recording. I'm planning to record the soloist guitar, which is also the guitar that does the introduction. So yeah, since we don't have any drum track in that part and the outro, of course, I'm just gonna follow my phone. So when the sun goes down, the original version, so that I can have the correct rhythm in the beginning of at the beginning of the song. So let's go. hit record. And go. Both first recording session of the videos, so the audio is all right. Now we need to record the video and then sync it up. So there's the camera that will record me. You will watch me from behind. Hey, don't be badasses. We start. Alright boys, rhythmic guitar moment, the exact same thing we did before. Let's get to it. Alright guys, soloist guitar is the last one, so there we go. So now I have recorded pretty much everything, including a part in the intro and the outro where I just play the chords, the initial and final chords. Now what's left is basically to sync what I played initially, so the music I produced in GarageBand and the videos that I produced with you with this camera. And yeah, then mix it up and upload it on my channel. So that's it. I don't really think there's much more to show, and I skipped purposefully all the part of post-production, so all the GarageBand mixing stuff, the iMovie stuff that are very, very boring and annoying. I just wanted to show you the part of the creation of the content. But if any of you needs a tutorial or anything like this on how to use GarageBand, like really basic stuff or iMovie or something like this, feel free to write down in the comments and I will be more than glad to help you. For now, I'm gonna say goodbye to you because I have two videos to edit now and I'm super happy. I hope you guys enjoyed and I will see you next time. Peace.